There's a second way to process this image through Topaz Photo AI. This is a more recent update. So we clicked on our image again, the original captured raw file, which I've converted to a DNG file. I come up to File, down to Plugin Extras, and across to Process with Topaz Photo AI. And it'll come up and offer, do I want to edit a copy, overwrite selected image, or cancel? Now I'm going to do a copy. I don't want to overwrite the original captured file. And that's just by experience habit, that I don't want to get rid of or change the original captured file. I go to edit a copy. It then loads up Topaz Photo AI. I'm going to drag that down. And at this time you can see it's really, really noisy, grainy, and soft. And over here you can see it's scanning the image and it's starting to process the image, and it'll do it to the AI or artificial intelligence autopilot setting over here on the right. And this can take a while. Again, it's using a lot of RAM, a lot of the CPU of the computer itself. Okay, and now we have the final processed version. So have a look at that. We've got the noise and grain of the original unprocessed raw file converted to a DNG, and now the processed version. Look at that. It is outstanding. What a job it's done. But the great news is, if I go save to Adobe Lightroom Classic down here, it will automatically drop it back into Lightroom for me, and it will do it as a DNG file. There you go. So by using Topaz Photo AI in this manner through File, I believe it does actually offer a better quality file. And of course, you end up with a DNG file, which for me is the best final file to actually have stored. So here's the original DNG file. You'll see the noise, sharp image, but not great detail. And here's the new DNG file. And again, look at the difference. So that's a digital negative raw file. Look at that fantastic looking detail, not processed yet. So I'm going to click on my Vibrance New, my favorite base processing. It's now processed that file. I'm going to come to the mask tool, click on subject. It's going to target the bird. I'm going to go to exposure and just up exposure a tiny bit. Shadows, definitely up the shadows so I can see more feather detail in there. Click done, and then I'm going to crop into and there's our final result. 10,000 ISO. Look at that at 100%. And look at the detail. Just amazing. Some might say it's not perfect. And obviously, it's going to have difficulties in this dark shadow areas. But considering it's a 10,000 ISO image, and when you compare it to the original RAW file or digital negative file, and the information of what was available and the amount of noise or grain that was available, that is quite an outstanding difference.